everyone, my name is Christina. Jumuriya so chuma Christina.
Hi everyone, my name is Danea. ¿Cómo está? Ako si Danea, and we're from the Long Beach Public Library.
Thank you for joining us for our food talk program, Rice for Breakfast Edition. This is part of our Asian Pacific Islander Heritage Month series that's going to run from May 1st to May 29th. We're highlighting today our Asian Pacific Islander foods. Let's get started. Danea, did you know that Cambodian Filipinos make up a very large portion of our Asian communities here in Long Beach?
That is a very good fact, and that's why we're here today. We're going to be showcasing wonderful dishes from Cambodian and Filipino cultures that both have rice.
And so today we're showcasing my dish here and Danea's. And so here my dish is actually called babaw sangmuan, which means rice porridge with chicken. And a memory that I have with this food is something that I would have commonly on the weekends with my family, kind of our version of brunch. And so a lot of times, because it's the weekend and we want to hang out with the family, we would actually go and eat this together at a restaurant.
Oh, and for my dishes, I have a savory and a sweet dish. And I just remember growing up and my dad would be cooking for us in the morning, and he would make either tocino or longaniza, which I'll get into later. But most of all, the suman, and my dad would be really excited about telling me how to add either certain things to it to make it like yummy. So just growing up and seeing these foods always bring back like a lot of good memories, and it fills my tummy, makes me happy.
Okay.
So let's take a look and let's get a closer look at our dishes. Christina, do you want to go first?
Sure.
Okay.
So this is a close-up of my dish here, which is called babaw sangmuan, which is pretty much a rice porridge or congee with chicken. And we also typically serve this with other meats like pork, which is sakchuruk, or trai, which is fish.
That's really interesting because, Christina, we have something similar in ours where it's a rice porridge and we usually have chicken and we call it arroz caldo. Your extras are a little bit different from mine, but they both look great to me.
Sure, I can introduce. I know it looks a little different, but here in this dish right here is a soybean paste, which has a salty fermented taste that we like to add to our bowl. And this is a sambal. It's pretty much like a spicier sriracha flavor. I love my dish with lots of lime and making it citrusy. So we also have lime as well. And we also have this interesting thing on the side here. Does it look kind of interesting to you, Danea?
Yeah, it looks really good. And I wasn't sure if it was sweet or savory, and since you mentioned.
Sure, it's actually savory. It's actually called Chinese donut, or in Khmer we say called cha kwai. Not donut in the way that we think, more like a beignet consistency. So it's really doughy and fluffy, and I like to eat it by ripping it up into pieces and throwing it into our bowl. Sometimes people like to dip this into the side drink, which a lot of times is accommodated with a Vietnamese iced coffee, which is really sweet. And so that makes for a really great byplay between salty and sweet.
Is that only for breakfast that you'd have the donuts?
Typically, this is only served with breakfast foods in the morning. So that's the only time you can find it.
Oh, that's really nice to know.
Sure.
Okay, well, I'm gonna get to mine. Let's check it out. Now it's time for me to showcase my Filipino dish. I will be starting with the savory dish first. And in this dish, I have garlic fried rice, I have tocino, eggs, and longaniza. Usually people can also have fish or a different type of meat when they're eating it for breakfast. Tocino is more of a sweet meat that you'd want, and there's also longaniza, which is a more savory sausage. It's a really good meat, and it mixes really well with each other. So now that I talked about my savory dish, I'm gonna move on to my sweet dish. And this is the one that I really have good memories with my dad, who would talk about the suman. So suman is sweet rice wrapped in banana leaves. And it can also have different types of sweet rice wrapped in banana leaves, and you'd have to know which one it is. And then for this dish, I'm actually pairing it with mango. You can also use sugar, or sometimes people use salt. It depends on what you want to do and your palate. Are there any questions, Christina?
Yeah, you know, this particular dish you have right here is very similar to what was showcased in Chenda's story time for Khmer New Year, which was Nom Som and different versions of that. So is this a sweet or savory dish?
So this one is A little bit more severe because they have salt in it, but there are other sweeter versions of suman in it. My mom, before I came, she was like, is that the cassava or is that? And I was like, no, this is just the regular one. And so she wanted to make sure that I was showcasing the right one. But I did notice that in the story time and your showcase, when Chanda was showcasing the many different types of the sweet rice in the banana leaves, it kind of made me really excited because we share something very similar. But then I really want to try your guys's like sweet rice in the banana leaves because there's a lip, you guys add all these other things to it too. Especially the jackfruit one, I really like that one. But yeah, so this is something that you could have in the morning time. And I love it because it reminds me of my dad. He's really excited showing me how to add anything to this to make it sweet or what we could use with mango. And he would be so excited about it. So yeah, oh, that's cool. It.
Thank you. Thank you for joining us today for our food talk program. We're really excited that you got to learn a little bit more about our cultures and hope that you will try out any of these recipes from any of our cookbooks in our Long Beach Public Library collection.
Or if not, you can even just go and check out any of the restaurants in Long Beach that serve Cambodian Filipino food.
Thank you guys. Have a good one.
We'll see ya.